Your landing page analytics can teach you quite a bit about your page engagement and the page visitors. For example, how many visitors have seen the page, how frequently they visit the page, and what parts of your page are most engaging. This information can help you either improve the design or keep up the good work.
To view your landing page analytics, navigate to Sites, select the page you'd like to review, and click on Overview. Click on Analytics, and here you can view your stats. So here we can see how many page views, how many unique visitors, and unique means that when a person visits your page at least once, he or she is counted only once in that reporting time period. So if a user visits your page again, it still counts as one unique visitor. We can also see how many subscribers you've collected through this page and the conversion rate, which is the percentage of users who subscribed to your newsletter. Now, in this graph, you can see how many visitors checked out your page and how many subscribed to your page. This is a heat map, and it shows you which sections of the page captured the most clicks and activity. You can see here that most of the heat is where we have buttons or interactive elements like a survey or a form. This is the subscribers list that my page collected, and you can export the list by clicking this button. Choose how you'd like to export it here. You can also toggle columns, and that will add more fields so you can display more information about your subscribers. If you don't have a heat map on your analytics page, don't worry, it's probably because it's not switched on. Let's navigate back to Overview, scroll down to Settings, and click on Edit Settings. Here we have additional information about your page, like your URL. You can add a favicon, which is the tiny little icon that appears on the page tab in your browser. And in the settings, I'll select the analytics and custom code. Here you can add your Google Analytics code, your Facebook pixel code. You can also disable the visitor analytics tracking by checking this box, but I don't recommend to do that because it's important to learn your visitors' engagement with your content. This is your header code injection and your page code injection. If you want to add custom code to your page, this is the place to do it. And lastly, this is where you switch on the heat map. And that's about all you need to know about your landing page analytics.
Thanks for watching. Make sure to click the bell button below so you don't miss any new tutorials. You can also find us on Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, and subscribe to our newsletter. The link is in the description section below. Have an awesome day or night, and I'll see you in the next video.